Hello, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about execute SQL task, and here we will discuss about the basic introduction. So let's start. So what is execute SQL task? Execute SQL task is one of the very important component in SSIS, because here we can run T SQL statements within control flow. And it has four options. First is general tab, second parameter mapping, then result set, and then expressions. So let's have a look of execute SQL task. So go to on SSDT, and here I need to add one more package. I wish to rename this package with execute SQL task basic introduction. Here I need to drag and drop execute SQL task. Then double click on this execute SQL task. As we can see, it has four options. First is general, then parameter mapping, result set, and expressions. So go to on general tab, and here I wish to start from SQL statement. So first is connection type. So in connection type, we need to select the connection manager type. As we can see, we have Excel, OLADB, ODBC, ADO, ADO.NET, and SQL Mobile. So these are the options available for connection type. Then in our second option, we have connection. So here we need to make the connection manager to connect with our database. Next is SQL server type. So in SQL server type, as we can see, we have three types. First is direct input, next file connection, then variables. So what are these three types? So basically, in direct input, we write the SQL queries directly into the SQL statement properties. In case of file connection, here we write down SQL queries into .sql or txt files, and then we need to create a connection for the same. Next, variables. In this case, we can write the queries into a variable, and then we can select that variable in source variable property. Next is bypass prepare. So as we can see over here, we have bypass prepare. It has true and false. So what it mean? So it indicates whether the task should prepare the query before executing. If we have true, then it indicates preparation is done by database engine by which we are connecting. If we select false, it indicates preparation is done by SSIS package. So this is for SQL statement. Let's go to on result set. So in result set, as we can see, we have four options. First is none, then single row, then full result set, then XML. If our SQL query would return only one row, then we can select single row. It doesn't matter number of columns. Number of column may be one or more than one, but number of row should be one. If you are getting the data from multiple rows, then we need to select our full result set. If we are getting the data in XML, then we need to select our XML option. If we are not getting any data, then we need to select none. So this is for a result set. So let's move to parameter mapping. So in parameter mapping, as we can see, we have many more columns. So what are these columns? So basically, in parameter mapping, first is variable name, the variable that contains the value to be used for the parameter. So our first is variable name. Next is direction. It determines whether to pass the value into the parameter as input parameter, or we are getting the value from the parameter as output parameter. Direction would be input or output. Next is data type. It determines the type of data provided from the variable, so we can select that. Next is parameter name. So here we can specify the order of the parameter, and it would start from zero. Our last is parameter size. The size of the parameter, if it can be a variable length, the default value would be -1, which lets SQL server determine correct size. For example, if we are getting in n varchar max, then size would be -1. So this is our parameter size. So go to on SSDT, and in our expressions. So it is a collection of expressions. The evaluation result of each expression is assigned to a property and replace the value of the property. In this case, we can use the expression in where clause of the SQL statement, where we want to assign value to column using variable. So this is use of expression. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.